Hello, one sec. Oh, this is the Coast Guard station here. Advise launch Ilfracombe lifeboat. West of all point.
We give the lifeboat the course to steer as soon as she's launched.
As soon as the lifeboat launches,
I will pass
this information
to the
crew.
Yeah, pass it on. Channel zero as soon as she launches.
Yeah, come this way a bit, burner on the beach.
That's it.
You've got more room this side than there, brother.
Female chase and just about make something in the water. He wouldn't be able to say whether that's a yacht, a fishing boat, or what it is. In fact, I think this is the lifeboat just beginning to come out now. This is Coast Guard Ilfracombe. Coast Guard Ilfracombe. Coast Guard Ilfracombe. Over. This is Coast Guard Ilfracombe, Channel Zero. Over. Would you advise your ETA at the carriage key position and pass your crew list as soon as possible? Over. Thank you.
Yeah, there you are. Step in there.
Feet first.
Step into that one, yeah. Feet first.
Right, foot. Foot.
Bring him over your head.
Right.
That's it.
Now this over my head.
This neck goes, you put your arm through there.
Yeah.
Over your head. Let's cover down the back.
Pull this down here.
Right. Here you are.
Pull your rod up.
Right, that's it. There you are.
Pull your rod up.
Tighten your belt. It gives you room in the neck for the muscle. And push your belt down like that.
Push the what down?
Push your belt down the back.
Up down the back.
That's it.
Right. Oh yes, you're quite warm in this, aren't you? Right, okay, I'm ready.
The palatine and all that sort of thing, you know?
Okay. Done. Incredible. You want me to stand here? What's the worst you've ever been in?
Well, quite rough.
Quite rough what? Force what?
9 to 10.
Force 9 to 10?
Yeah.
Now, when it's that bad, can you stand up here?
No.
Too bad for anybody.
Yeah.
So where do you go?
You'll go back out.
And just hope for the best. How do you know whether you can see anything?
Well, I mean, when you get to wherever you're sent to a certain place to search, like, you know.
Yes.
When you get there, and your ears are down a bit, you start to search, then, you see.
But, oh. And if you shout at people, can you hear what you're saying?
Well, you're all straight backwards, you can't shout into it, right? Like, you know. I mean, there's a core when you want to hear it, you know.
Radio there. We put it on channel zero.
Channel zero, that's where?
That's the Coast Guard frequency. And we call the Oakley-class Coast Guard. Oakley-class Coast Guard, Oakley-class Coast Guard. This is Oakley-class Lifeboat. Oakley-class Lifeboat, do you read? Over.
Coast Guard, this is Ilfracombe Lifeboat. We have launched and we are on service. Launched and on service. Over.
Coast Guard, Ilfracombe, listen out on zero.
And that's all. You keep them posted as to where you're going,
that's
who you're
right,
what's happening,
yes.
And who you found. And
that's right. We pass every bit of information back to them.
This is the driest place in the lifeboat, isn't it?
Yes.
That's
right.
Why you got your job,
that's
isn't it?
That's why I got my job, then, yeah.
Do you keep supplies down here for survivors, like coffee, anything? Do you have anything for
them? We have in the lockers on the opposite side food, biscuits, chocolate, and we've also got a bottle of brandy there. Yeah.
I think you'd better bring that out for me when I'm rescued.
Well, we'll do that.
There's no cabin space in this lifeboat.
No, this lifeboat is originally designed to operate in around a 10-mile range. That's about an hour's steaming, so that we don't consider cabin space as necessary.
Where does it go?
Oh, around about 9 miles an hour.
I see. And does it always point that way?
I'm not quite sure what you mean. Does it always point that way?
Stupid question.
Well, it seems to be,
no,
you know.
Up and down.
I forget that.
Yeah.
How many crewmen are there?
A 7 crew. That's a coxswain, second coxswain, 3 deckhands, and 2 mechanics.
And you're the chief mechanic?
That's right, yeah.
And you have a full-time job looking after it?
That's right, yes.
Is there a lot of work to do?
Well, there's a lot of work to do, particularly after the boat's been at sea.
And all this inside here is the engine?
That's right, yes. This is the engine room, completely sealed when we're at sea.
Yes. And this shed, how old is the shed?
Well, it's built in early 1860s.
That's quite.
So we've had a boat on the station since 1866. Yeah.
It's quite modern, isn't it, this boat?
Yes, it's built in 1966, 8 years. This is where the chap lands when he's coming down from the helicopter. When they land.
Oh, when he comes down.
Winchman, he comes down and lands on here. It's the least dangerous place to land. He could land on the engine cover, but it's not quite so good. We can grab hold of him fairly quickly, but all the crew are a little bit wary of catching hold of winchmen when they come from helicopters because of the static.
Because of the what?
Static.
What's that?
Well, you get the static electricity builds up in the aircraft, and when he touches, if you reach up and grab him, you'll get a shock, you see.
I think I'm going to have to grab that one.
Oh, yeah. Well,
thanks for warning.
It's not very much.
Do you have a feeling of pride about this boat?
Oh, very much so. If it's not clean or anything like that, well, then that's a black mark against me, isn't it? In fact, my missus is giving me a stick.
Your wife feels very strongly about your job, does she?
Oh, yes. She's on the store Wednesday evenings, and she always has a crafty little look around the boat to make sure everything's in order,
you see. And when she comes home, does she tell you what's wrong?
Oh, yes, she tell me.
Like what?
Yeah. Well, the propellers aren't shining. She soon tell me about it.
sort of turning out of bed, you know, and especially if you haven't been in for quite a long time and you're the rocket crush, I'm in the lifeboat, you know. What do I do, you know? And it takes a few hours to get sort of gather your senses together and that, and you realise you've got a job to do and to get over it.
Are you ever conscious of the danger of it?
Oh, no, I'm conscious of it, naturally, because you've got to respect the old Father Neptune, you know, and Mother Nature. But at the same time, you get, you get an affinity for it, you know. And,
what do you mean?
Well, I've had a boat since I was nine.
You like
I should have drowned years ago, you know, according to the local old boatman. But I'm still here, you know, and
what have you got on display?
Oh, yes, it's building up, you know, now with the fine weather's coming along, let's see, yeah.
Come and show me the rest of what you've got.
Oh, this is our, first shop
all
here.
All these naughty postcards and naughty gimmicks you've got.
Oh, yeah, well, I don't think you ought to get too much of a close-up because you might shock. This is writers and people like that. Yeah.
Does this shop survive on a few months of the year tourist trade?
Oh, yes, because the only reason we survive is that you have to work 7 days a week, you see, and...
What, you're open Sundays, everything?
Oh, every day, 7 days a week, and I generally start... I'm up at 5:30, scrubbing the front down, cleaning the windows, and filling up the postcards, and general dog's body, you know, cleaning up and getting the things
shipped. So how many months do you have to earn your year's income?
Oh, well, it doesn't really start. I suppose I do most of me. I can do half my income in about 4 weeks.
4 weeks.
Yeah, that's where you have to really have to go sometimes.
And why are you a lifeboat man?
Oh, because I just feel I like to help my fellow men, you know. If I can help someone as I'm passing by, you know.
Someone's got to go, you know.
What's your feeling about the sea? Do you think it's the sea is a friend or an enemy?
It's there to be travelled over, aren't we? I mean, you take England's history. You see, not many years ago we were in court of the world, didn't we?
Any boat for sailing? Take your tickets here.
We wouldn't get the money without the ladies at all. We've put hours and hours of work in, you know. Our great difficulty is, really, getting people to help.
Who organises it?
Well, there's myself, there's the chairman, and we have a committee of 11 people.
And what are you called?
The Ilfracombe Ladies Lifeboat Guild.
And what do they haul in every year?
Well, I don't know what they haul in over the country, but I know this our stall here last year took £2,400.
Is there any status attached to being a lifeboat man?
I think they're very brave. People.
No,
there's no status attached to it, no.
No status at all.
None at all.
You'll find that the crew, and the Ilfracombe crew, are very reserved. They don't make any fuss about it and they don't want any praise.
They don't even think about it. I mean, the rockets go and they're down here. I mean, where I live, we have one of the launchers and he's a school teacher. And we often say, you know, when the rockets go out at night, Bob is on his way down here before the second rocket's gone. And I say, turn to my husband and I'll say, there's Bob. He sounds as though he's on Brown's hatch.
What's your job?
I'm the honorary secretary responsible for the administration of the lifeboat employed by the RNLI. When you say employed, it's purely a voluntary job.
I see. So you work for free?
I work for free, yes.
And when the call comes through, the distress call, does it come to you?
Yes, it's normally via the Coast Guards or from the police. Normally via the Coast Guards, they give the first intimation.
But you're the first man normally to get that call?
That's right, yes.
How many people on the crew get some sort of payment?
Well, the coxswain himself gets a retainer. The mechanic gets a full-time pay. He's the only full-time employee we've got.
What sort of full-time pay would he get?
About £23 a week.
£23 a week?
Yes, it depends how long he's been with the service.
And who else gets?
The coxswain gets a retainer, an annual retainer of £150 a year. The second coxswain gets a small retainer.
What sort of amount?
About £75.
Yeah.
The assist a mechanic gets a small amount as well.
How much would he get?
About £4 a quarter.
If you're up the High Street, I suppose they would be called, they call them townies up there. You're a Keyite down here, this part of the town is a different sort of two communities, you know, in this town. Everybody earns a living down here, you know, by the sea. Most of the fishing now is gone, though, the inshore fishing.
Why has that happened?
Well, lack of fish, railways closing down, a lot of people moving into the area, I suppose.
Do you like that?
Not really, no.
Why not?
Well, I like to keep it as it is, the town as it is, you know.
How do you feel about the sea when it's rough weather?
Oh, I like the sea, I respect the sea, but it don't affect me at all.
You've got your crew under control, have you?
Yeah.
They do what you say?
Yeah.
In all weather?
Yeah, very good crew at the moment. But it's been voluntary for so many years, you know, it's not. I don't think it's going to change now.
That's making me slightly sick, watching you do that. It doesn't do anything for you, I suppose.
Not really, no. It's nice when you're out there, isn't it? Quiet, peace of mind. It's a job I like. Sometimes you feel like, you know, you see, what am I doing out here? You feel that way sometimes.
You've never thought you might be killed by the sea?
Well, yeah, you do think of that, I suppose. You could be all drowned. I mean, boats have been lost, lifeboats, haven't they? All hands.
Have you ever said prayers out at sea?
No, I don't say prayers.
Last in that cold.
Well, women can last longer than men, probably.
Women last longer than men. I mean, I had no idea it was so cold. What do you pick people up after half an hour? And if you're left longer, you just don't last, do you?
Well, you should be able to in these waters.
Thank you.
along here. Not too close. One there.
Right, it won't happen.
All right. Get a couple in up there, all right? Come on. Yeah. Right, keep it going.
Off and you alright?
Okay. Take out your wedges then. Stand by on that wedge, somebody.
That's it, she's coming. Oh, lovely. Beautiful.
Do all the survivors get this treatment?
Oh, certainly not. Only the good-looking ones.
This is the best time of the day. Out of the sea, out of the air, nearly 2 feet away from dry land. Thank you, gentlemen.
Coming down.
Thank you, dry land. I just...
This programme was filmed some years ago. Next Tuesday morning at 10 past 10, there's another chance to...